So the step we're going to focus on today is starting your search. So what do you do? Where do you go? You might have spent the last 3 or 4 years sitting at the back of a classroom, studying diligently to pass your exams, but a lot of that environment was quite passive. Unfortunately, a lot of higher level education in general is very passive, and sometimes that does not prepare candidates for the type of self-starting, energetic and proactive approach you really need to secure your early experience in the labor market. So being prepared and starting your search really involves stepping up with your inner circle as your first priority. That means your friends and your family. Believe it or not, you may think they are aware that you're looking for a job, but remind them, like a mantra, tell them, look, I need to meet people in these different sectors. I want to develop these particular skills. I want to work for a large multinational, or I want to work for a small local business. You need to be as clear and confident with these people as possible. You would be incredibly surprised how important these people can be with the next stage of your life. After that, look closely at your university careers hub. You might have passed it 100 times and not stopped to ask those people, can they help? It is incredible how valuable their resources might be. Once you've got a professional looking LinkedIn, and please remember to have a professional photograph. You know, if I had a dollar for every amateur Facebook type photograph I've seen on LinkedIn, I'd be a millionaire. You really need a professional image on a career or professional website like LinkedIn. You need your words to be accurate. You need your pitch to be concise. And to include power words or keywords which resonate with your employer in your particular industry. And you need to make a very strong and positive impression as somebody who a prospective employer would like to employ. So social media has a very important role to play in terms of your search. LinkedIn itself is evolving all the time, and they have some fantastic employment resources. So consider that like a banner advertisement for your first career opportunity. You need to look very, very closely at networking opportunities in your specific industry. Pretty much every month, events happen. It's like a secret world. If you've been a student, you know, hanging out at the University of Sydney or Melbourne, and you're familiar with a very particular group of people, well, you find that there's a very particular clique or group of dedicated professionals who stick together, communicate with each other, and love to get together at networking events. Find out where and when those networking events are happening. The most important tip for this stage of your internship experience is to start searching proactively. You cannot sit back and wait for it to happen. You need to go out there, grab the opportunity, and let everybody know you're going for it. Good luck.